Okay, I think you didn't get my question. That's okay, Vaishali.
Sorry.
Last thing that I want to understand from you is, if you have to change one thing about yourself, what would that be?
Ma'am, I can't think of... I'm very comfortable with my own self, so I can't think of anything.
Okay, thank you so much, Vaishali.
Thank you, ma'am.
Tell us something about you.
Sir, I'm Vaishali Jain. I was born and brought up in Delhi. After graduating from Delhi Technological University, I completed my post-graduation in mechanical design from IIT Delhi in the year 2018. Sir, after that, I cleared engineering services examination, on the basis of which I have been allotted Border Road Engineering Services. Sir, this is my second civil services attempt. And sir, my hobbies include Madhubani painting, paper quilling, and reflective diary writing.
So, Vaishali, you're already with the Border Road Engineering Services?
Sir, I'm expected to join this September.
Expected to join this September. And you were trained to be an engineer?
Yes, sir.
You are an engineer?
Yes, sir.
Then why are you here?
Sir, because of the wider opportunity set that civil services offers, and also the diversity that is there in civil services. And sir, I think that I'll be able to derive greater satisfaction from it.
Well, I understand those aspirations, Vaishali, but you must be given this mechanical engineering thing in the VRE?
Yes, sir.
And if I'm right, not many women engineers at that level are there in this organization.
Yes, sir.
Do you understand that you are at a historical moment? You can be a person who can lead the mechanical engineering organization in that organization and India in general. Becoming another civil servant is like one in the crowd. And the opportunity you have is very, very rare. It is something that you'll be inspiring the entire generation of girls. So why are you leaving that opportunity to get into and become something which many, many women have done? I'm not saying that it is a mean thing. It is important. What you can do right now is something which is was unthinkable for women many, many years.
Sir, I do agree that the representation of women in mechanical as well as the Border Road Engineering Services is low. But sir, I think with my academic record, I might have inspired many candidates to take up mechanical engineering. And sir, the idea of civil services is more about me, and I can also display the leadership qualities within civil services as well.
You can, but that is something which many women have already done.
Yes, sir.
What you can do right now is something which not many Indian women have done. So I'm proud to meet you.
Thank you, sir.
And this is a movement that you should not run away from. And think of those girls whom you believe that you inspired. They look at this movement of yours as if you're running away because of the hardships from that place. I'm sure you're not that kind of a girl.
Sir, if I had to run away, I wouldn't have pursued my post-graduation also in mechanical engineering. And sir, hardships are equal in the engineering services as well as the civil services, because both are central civil services or all India services. Sir, idea to get into the civil services was to have greater outreach with the people. And sir, there the base is so huge that I'll be able to inspire more women, sir.
Well, you very clearly understand that we are not on the same page on that, but let's leave that. What was your optional? Obviously, mechanical engineering,
sir.
Right. And your graduation was specialized in automobiles.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tell me, if we look at this ethanol blending policy of Government of India, as a mechanical engineer, tell me that why this ethanol blending will not lead to knocking when we talk about IC engines?
Sir, the government aims to blend the 20% of ethanol in the present gasoline engines. And sir, that is why it will improve the emission characteristics of the engine. If we use ethanol greater than 85% in an engine, then we can have the chances of detonation. But in that case also, we can modify the engine for the suitability of the fuel, sir.
But in comparison to a pure fuel, and when we talk about the blended fuel, as an engineer, don't you see the possibility of knocking increasing because of ethanol?
Sir, up to 5% blending does not require any engine modification in the existing design. Up to 20%, we need to tweak the engine designs, we need to replace the steel pipes, fuel lines, that are there in the engine with the nickel coating on them. Otherwise, the ethanol will corrode it. So, we need to introduce minor modifications like.
So, you're talking about the long term impact of having ethanol in the pipelines. I'm talking about the combustion.